There we are. So, as I said, the impetus for this is the pandemic. We had to postpone those tours of walking and music in Scotland in the summer, both last summer and this summer. These are some of the musicians that would have joined us to meet the small groups that we take with us and play the music so that people get a chance to actually experience some of the music in the context of the place that it comes from, which is really nice. Meanwhile, it's really nice for the musicians to have a chance to share their music with you and for you to get to hear them. It's been a year and a half without the live gigs. If you wish to donate on the concert page, there's a button there. There's also information about each of the performers and a link to their website so you can learn more about them. And at the top of the page, there's links to information about the music and walking trips and the fiddle-online site that's sponsoring the concert. It's a really great pleasure to share this music with you all today. I want to thank Dorothy and Margaret for working with me on these, and Dorothy will be sharing some photos of Scotland a couple of times during the show. I also want to thank my son Neil, who's an excellent musician in his own right, but is here to help with some of the technical stuff today. Today we're going to have a chance to listen to some great players on the fiddle, Gaelic song, harp, Scottish song, bagpipes, and accordion. So it's going to be a really great show. I hope you enjoy it. We're going to get started with Alistair McCulloch. Alistair is one of Scotland's best fiddle players and teachers, and is based in the southwest of Scotland in Ayr, the Burns country. And he gets permission to perform on the Greg fiddle, which used originally belonged to Robert Burns's dancing master, and that Burns himself may have played, because he seemed to have played fiddle. Don't have perfect evidence, but it seems to be true. Alistair has won many fiddle competitions, championships. He's a fiddle instructor at the Royal Conservatoire in Scotland. He tours with his own trio, the Alistair McCulloch Trio, and he runs a fiddle weekend called, appropriately for his area, the Land of Burns. So please welcome Alistair McCulloch. Hello, Alistair. Thanks for joining us, and we look forward to hearing some great tunes. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, everyone, and good evening, and good afternoon to those of you in the USA. It's great to be part of your concert this evening from Scotland. And as Ed mentioned, it would have been really nice to meet up in person, but hopefully in 2022. Well, I kicked off the show there with a medley of tunes, starting off with a tune written by John Morris Rankin, the late John Morris from Cape Breton. That was the last march. And then an Irish reel called The Guns of the Magnificent Seven. And the last reel I composed about 10 years ago after a musical tour to China. And it's called Trip to Shanghai. So I'm going to continue now with a medley of tunes again. Starting off with a tune I wrote last year. Ed mentioned the Greg fiddle, and I'm very honoured and lucky to be really the only musician allowed to play the instrument. And it comes out a few times a year. Sadly, not this evening. It's still in the Burns Museum in Alloway at the moment. But the first tune I'm going to play, I actually wrote on the instrument about this time last year. And it was donated for auction to the National Trust for Scotland, USA. And it's entitled Bruce Robert Burton, and it's a slow air. So after that, I thought it would be appropriate to play a few tunes associated with Robert Burns. And I'm going to play a two-stress bass, starting off with Whistle Over the Lavet, and then going into a tune which I really like. It was written by the great fiddle composer William Marshall. It's called Admiral Gordon Strathspey. And Burns adapted it for his very famous song, Of All the Airts, The Wind Can Blow. And I'll finish the medley with a jig, which I enjoy from Burns. And it's a great song. I'm sure you'll recognise it. The Deals Awa with the Excisemen. But first of all, I'm going to play the slow air, Bruce Robert Burton.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, it's unusual to be actually sitting here wearing a pair of shorts and playing to a laptop. But as Ed said, it's been a long time since we played live music over here in Scotland, but things are improving. I have my first live show 2 weeks today. That'll be the first one for a year and a half, so really looking forward to that. It's actually really hot in Scotland at the moment as well, so I've got windows open and all sorts. And very soon, there'll be a very important football match kicking off. I'm sure you're all aware of that one, so I hope that doesn't distract you from tonight's concert. And we, of course, we wish England all the very best. I'm a good liar. Before I play my final set of tunes, I would like to say a very big thank you to Ed for inviting me along to be part of the show this evening. It's always a real pleasure to meet Ed with these musical groups in various parts of Scotland. And it's a shame, as I said, that we can't meet in person this year. But roll on 2022, and hopefully next time you'll be able to hear the Greg Fiddle at the Burns Museum in Alloway. So I'm going to finish up with a medley of pipe tunes. And the first tune's not so well known. It's a retreat march, which I really like. It's slightly out of season at the moment because it's called Christmas Rose. And then it'll merge into a 2-4 march called John McCall's March to Colbowie Cottage. And I'm going to finish up with a well-known pipe jig called Inspector Donald Campbell of Ness. So thanks very much for having me. Do enjoy the rest of the show. There's some great performers, so enjoy tonight's concert. And thanks again to Ed and to all you folks for coming along. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Amazing. Thank you, Alistair. That was beautiful playing. I'm sure some of you are out there dancing. There's plenty of floor space, by the way, in your houses. So feel free to get up and shake a leg. Thanks again. It was really beautiful playing. We're going to hear now some beautiful Gaelic singing from Gillibridge and Macmillan. He's originally from South Uist in the Outer Hebrides, and where Gaelic was his first language. And songs, Gaelic songs and tradition were, you know, an important part of family life as he grew up. He performs Gaelic song, and he also teaches Gaelic at the university. His recordings include both traditional songs and new ones that he has composed, which are all in Gaelic. And you might have seen him in the Stars production of Outlander. He was Gwilym the Bard with a wig, in case you get confused. And he regales the castle with traditional Gaelic songs and tales. So please welcome Gillibridge Macmillan for some great songs. Hello, Gillibridge. Thank you for joining us.
Hi, it's good to be here. And Ed, you've just given the game away. I was going to say I just had a haircut, but
sadly not. Oh, sorry. Yeah, that was your real hair.
But yeah, it's great to be here. And I was just thinking a moment ago, Ed, the first time I met yourself was at the Oberlin Scottish Games in Ohio in 2006. And yes, it's been a real pleasure to meet you at in Glencoe and in South Uist every year, certainly for the last number of years. With your tour groups, and certainly I hope to hope everything comes back to normal in 2022 and we can have your walking tours and music tours back over. So I'm going to sing for you a Gaelic song just now called Dolta Gwisht, Going to Uist. It's a song composed in the Glasgow area by the man known as the Paisley Bard. It was Donald McIntyre, and this time tomorrow or tonight, many people through the years would have been preparing to go home for the 2 weeks of the Glasgow Fair Fortnight. So the Glasgow Fair Fortnight is in the olden days when Glasgow used to shut down for 2 weeks, and that starts tomorrow. So they would go home to whatever place they were going to see the friends they hadn't seen for 50 weeks, enjoy being at home, whatever that is. Many of them would go to Ireland, and the rest, I'm sure, would go to the Highlands and Islands. And this song is called Going to Uist, and it talks about the journey from leaving Glasgow on the train, going up to Mallaig, past the small isles of Cana and Eigg, over to Barra, and then meeting your friends in Uist. And if you've ever been on some of Ed's tours, you'll know that the Loch Boisdale, where the ferry comes in, has a beautiful, lovely hotel. So the first stop would always be the hotel and the pub to find out what the news of the last year had been. So this is Dolta Gwisht. Oro lenlein nach chukinyo liom sara chamich tach gana gaik inyar tuha yev shinyan tasha get batan as mu jelikalar kur se dhinish nambo. Huad shingan chara pata galaga huad och noch gedig dhian ag es bial awen chluailin yedig moch dhia dhim uloch nam fua vewn sounds and the tua hoke shinyog a jid a di ranya cha shalag edin ach na bewn dynion ars da mar iar da gartuf ye Gwyd i'ch moch alach ddi falig yn rwg, sfa os ac na gwy har cyllun yn cro. Siach y dloch a byr hig siali yn nŵr, o'n chi sy'n bennu fas sy'n eisiau dar cwlw. Chosin a mwloch i wr am y chrwn, si fados yr cywn a falach sy'n yol. Fag ysyn malai gyd bad yn y smw, chysad o'n lapan y gorod na hiwrych, Cuddy and I'm picking the cool sculpture room is the line you Shachet Kaun Hanai Garen and Kuan Chin Shia Panamara Nahat Harakuaye Toki Shin Parai Hat Baron and Stuas Compassion Tua the Yishnam Bo O Yishnan Narsan Mograd Twitchin to Helichen Lodge the Sasanam Hlia Shetu yin nayam sentar yimishes hanak nyujes me pink and doy. Noedrikes min kia havi mi fogrua man kani hia fichete hik and of tua mi. Ha wed chinya gavikenish ruai nach chukin shin suas kem fire mit stop. Horo lemon nach chuk nyu lium sara hamich tach kana gaik nyar tuha yev shinyan tasha ke patana smooch yakal or cool say thinish nimbo. Tapalisha, thank you very much. And so, as I mentioned, that was a song about going to Uist. And of course, I'm from Uist and hopefully I'll be going there soon myself. I live in Glasgow at the moment and I teach at the University of Glasgow. And so over the last year, all our classes have been on Zoom. So I'm quite used to Zoom nowadays. But I suppose once you're in Uist, having gone for the fair fortnight, one of the things you'd love to do would be to go fishing. So next I'm going to sing you a song called Oran Ningimach, the Song of the Lobsters. And this song was composed by a local bard called Shawnee Campbell, or John Campbell. And he composed the song as he was a stonemason, he was a fisherman, and he was a crofter. And many of the people back in the day, and still in Uist, they would have lots of different jobs to make ends meet. So he was a stonemason and a fisherman. And he tells a story in the song about going to fishing, how it's a difficult job, but it gets much easier when there are two lobsters in the creels. And when there are three, it becomes a great job. And of course, when you go back to the pub, the lobster that was this size, first of all, by the end of the night, is this size. So this song is called Oran Ningimach, the Song of the Lobsters.
Ilan Hanyal Tulam Kerjuvik and Feodach, Nuan Apiro Tunes, Bacon Sunda Visornia, O Ilan Hanyal Tulam Kerjuvik and Feodach, Sauna Nopathian Alatarin, and Glyph Shask and Fine, and Viat Very Yari, them Falkage, Ilan Hanyal Tulam Kerjuvik and Feodach, Nuan Apiro Tunes, Bacon Sunda Visornia, O Ilan Hanyal Tulam. Could you be comforted? Speaking rock, however, no the first yawn. Could Gian Mishika the sneas and permoria? Ian Hanyal Tulum, could you be comforted? Nor Napiro Tunes, Beckon Sunda Visornia. Oh, Ian Hanyal Tulum, could you be comforted? Nach penope the gaminges can be fine fernde. Barry ounce yallich knack and tarring yed and doisho. In Hanyal Tulum could you be comforted? No an appear of tunes, beck and soon the visornia. Oh, in Hanyal Tulum could you be comforted? Getrach in com gulan hat all me a grundat, mar haet le cru paike you see in chorn, o in chanya tulam kju vik am feodach, nor na piro tun pek and soon da visornia, o in chanya tulam kju vik am feodach, speing roch haver, nor the persian, kjian mishikades nias and permoria. Ilin Hanyal Tulum could you be comforted? No an appear of tunes, beck and soon the visornia. Oh, in Hanyal Tulum could you be comforted? Sound with some tallin gin, worthy curse of tree, and Kunyashi with cheat at the Kisha Kastadi. Hilin han yatulam kajuvikam feodach. Nuan apirutun spekin sunda visarnia. O yin han yatulam kajuvikam feodach.
Tapalisha, Adish, thank you very much. It's great to see so many friendly faces, people I've known from various trips to the US, and some Outlander fans I know are here as well. And so it's great. And also I see May Kessler, who's done a wonderful video for one of my songs from my previous album. The song was called Santiago. So check that out. May's video is a fantastic dance of seven generations dancing, choreographed dance. But I'm going to sing you another song from my previous album, which is Thiavan Falhche, Hidden Roots, which is an album of songs I composed myself. And it's just to let you know as well that I've just come back just a couple of weeks ago from the recording studio where I was recording another album of all my own compositions. So there'll be a new album coming soon. And I think I love the old songs we have in Gaelic, but it's also very important to remember that Gaelic is a living tradition and living language, and that it's great to see so many new songs being composed. And there's been a kind of renaissance of Gaelic song composition in the last number of years. So I'm very happy to be a part of that, and look out for my new album coming soon. But this song is called A Chaling Down, or Brown Haired Girl. And I composed it in 2015, and it was the time of the Syrian refugee crisis. And I'm sure you'll remember the pictures of a little boy who was sadly washed up on the shore in Greece. And it was really just, I was struck by the sadness of that. But also I composed this song from the perspective of those who were in desperation, putting their children onto the boats, wishing for them an outstretched hand and someone to look after them over on the other side. So this is A Chaling Down.
A chaling down an ian down mar chayun nu har sala mogurach gut gam birtu swan le unach krages sonnes gut chaling down an ian down von chunig mischen hoschuchu stu schesun schin am choni jadich mischen kthiet o schlema buole traum nam cholinse chalin daun nian daun Leunach krages sonnes gut, hoku arschle toches, gam birgen solas kutje du taun, set baiken kudu eoles, chalin daun, nian daun. Nur noch gest du etraun, gampfas klar gut an garschen, genschiner gut am machen, lamle tückches karstes madden noch, chalin daun, nian daun. Ach, o mor hwain a chadw gwyb, gy crwai a fwal e adysia, yn slwch o was o glwys yn nawm yn eich les garw cradioch, chalin dawn yn ian dawn. Mar chayunul har sal Macruaia vuale adisha An sluachos og buas Nau menish leskari krajach Chalin daun ni an daun.
Appalachia, thank you very much. So that was a song composed by myself. And if you're interested in finding out a bit more about that song, there was also it was set to choral music by the choir director of the University of Glasgow, Katie Lavinia Cooper, and the choir did a fantastic job of singing the song. So it's available on YouTube and so on. But I thought I would sing you another new composition I'm going to make you kind of guinea pigs for tonight. And this song is a song I was recently commissioned to compose by the artist Judith Parrott. And she's a visual artist, but she's been working on the folklore tradition of the Cailleach, which is the old hag or the old woman in Scotland who was the kind of the goddess of the Scotland. She's known as the creator of Scotland. She's known as somebody who commands the weather. It's also known, you may have seen about the Corrivrechan whirlpool. Now in folklore, the story goes that she is washing her plaid in the water there. So that's why the water is boiling up and so on. And also, I'm sure if you've been to Scotland, you will look at some of the mountains and some of the bends, and you will see what appears to be the face of a woman sleeping. You can see the nose and the eyes and the mouth and so on. So it's the story goes that the goddess, the Cailleach, which means old woman in Gaelic, was the creator of Scotland. She controlled the weather, and she caused the Corrivrechan whirlpool. So this is the story of the Cailleach.
Sheen chami fatimalin sinji shaw was a garstly shalagadi. She just cheeches misha yeeshes. Cruyer na halap me, cruyer na lochan me, na mewn na glawn cachalt is esru. Cruyer gach carig me, cruyer gach rua me, gach stwag idd cwan, gach sgeddys gdegu. She jiggig a velu hain fom stjursa vo huole kruotels palches fuochlet. Kruier na halap mi, kruier na lochan mi, na mbaun na glaun kachaltis es hru. Cruyer gach carig mi, cruyer gach rua mi, gach stwag idd cwan, gach sgeddys gdegw. Bdeach gan gdyn segl na pharaig ffom laifse, bych yn stwag y dol ma'n gwrs le glan y swani. Crwyr na halap mi, crwyr na'n lochan mi, na'n mewn na'n glawn cachal dy sesrw. Cruyer gach carig mi, cruyer gach rwa mi, gach stwag idd cwan, gach sgeddys cregw.
Thank you very much. Happy Easter.
Thank you very much, Gilibrija. That was amazing. Beautiful. The Gaelic songs has a special quality. It's hard to describe. It's great to listen. Even if people don't understand the words, it's just so lilting and beautiful. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'd like to introduce Dorothy and Margaret just now. Dorothy is the person that I work with in our trips. She's on the right.
The other right.
And Margaret helps us as well in the office and make things happen. Dorothy leads the walks on our trips because she's done that. They've done this for many decades. I've worked with the musicians for many decades, so I hold together a musical portion of our trips, and it's just a really nice time for small groups. And Dorothy is going to take us through some photos of places that we've been in Scotland. So Dorothy, thank you. On to you.
Thank you. Thanks, Ed.
Yeah.
It's great to see everybody, and thanks for coming. Ed's just going to do the technical bits. I just do the talking. So the photographs are maybe some of the places that we see, but there's also just some general photographs of Scotland that are quite nice. If you've never been here, it's a very small country. Thanks, Ed. But a very next, I think that's what the clue that we were working on. Sorry, what was I saying? Yes, okay. It's a very diverse country for being such a small area. And it has, because of that, there's a great deal of variety of landscapes, lots of spiky mountains next, and close to the sea as well. So you're going from some of the rocks that are the oldest in the world, just about, to some very young rocks. This is a view of the Hebrides and looking across to, I think, south east. On we'll go. Thanks. Next, Ed. Not quite used to this technology, but I usually just press a button. So as I say, lots of spiky mountains, but the thing is, the landscapes are easily accessible and easy to walk through, and you don't have to go up to the tops. In fact, some of the best views are from the glens and the valleys itself, which is where people would have lived for the bulk of the time. Thanks. Next, Ed. And for example, this is a part of the West Highland Way that we've walked on bits before. And so you're just wide open landscapes and usually good views. I can't guarantee the sunshine, and not all the photographs are perfect weather, but the mixture is actually what makes Scotland so interesting. You just have to wait for 5 minutes and the weather changes. Next. And even when the clarity of the light is not so good, then it's still very impressive and easily accessible. The light from a painting point of view, from an artist's point of view, is actually phenomenal. And the summertime, we've got these big, long, delayed evenings almost, and it's called the gloaming here. Next. And it just gives you a very stunning changing of light patterns, and having some cloud in the sky just helps to make everything settle down. Next. As I say, we go to a variety of places. Some are over in the Hebrides, so this is over in Harris, and I think we were actually walking on the little island of Scalpe, which is just off the coast of Harris, and just stunning scenery, easily accessible. Get to meet some local people, explore the local area, get a real good feeling for the culture of the locations that we visit. Next. The Hebrides is very much a strong heartland of Gaelic speaking, but we visit lots of other parts of Scotland. So down in the south, there's a very strong, and the east as well, it's a very strong Scots dialect. And we might hear some of that later on. Next. But part of it, as I say, is really quite impressive. So here are some rocks that are supposedly 3,000 million years old. anyway, long time ago. Next. And we have some dinosaurs as well. So we have some Jurassic rocks in Skye, which are probably one of the most varied islands that we have. And dinosaurs are obviously discovered in Scotland and started in Scotland. Their origins are Scottish, because we identified the face paint that they used for when they went out partying. Next. But the peoples of Scotland, the indigenous peoples of Scotland, came here many, many thousand years ago. This is an archaeological dig up in the islands of Orkney, which are just off the north coast. And they are some 5,000 years old plus and going back. So they long predate the pyramids and Stonehenge and lots of places. And for being somewhere stuck in the northwest tip of the northwest tip of Europe, it might actually have been the center of the civilization at that time, given that some of the information that they're discovering. Next. But these parts of the landscape are still there, and they form an important part of the cultural aspect, and it's just part of everyday living. So it's included in the local history and the local folklore, and song and writing and traditions are all associated with it. Next. And I think that's one of the amazing things about the tours that you're walking through and getting to experience not just the landscapes and so on, but it's actually getting a real flavour of the area and where the songs and the music came from. Next. And this cultural diversity is actually really important, and it's still there. I mean, Gilibrija was saying about song taking place just now and lots of writing. So it's still very vibrant, and it's a very dynamic position just now for Scotland, I think. Next. So this is a Scarab Ray, so one of the prehistoric houses that were uncovered by storms off the coast. Next. A lot of the travel in the past, and particularly until maybe the last century or so, has been by sea. And a lot of the early civilizations and habitations were on the coast. And they still have a very strong pull, next, to how life is lived. The influence is not just from Scots, we're a mixture of a whole lot of races, I suppose. So there's a lot of Norse influence, especially in the very north, far north. Parts of Shetland, for example, is nearer to Norway than it is to Scotland. And they've got very strong traditions of their own about the Viking era. Next. But people have lived in the landscape and not nearby, so there's lots of evidence of small settlements, not big towns and cities, but just small settlements and small hamlets where people lived in family groups. Next, in stunning locations, and the culture and so on is so deeply rooted that it comes from the place. And Gilibrija was talking about the Celiach and being the mother of Scotland and so on, then you can just sort of see just by being there how that would influence people if you actually lived there for your whole life. Next. This is over in Eileen Donan. So we have some iconic pictures that are always on calendars everywhere, but they're set in actually real places. And as I say, the history and heritage associated with it is quite impressive. Next. You really want to hear some music, but anyway. Not all mountains are inaccessible, but lots of the walking that we do is pretty easy and straightforward, and just following old routes that people would have used in the past. And particularly, I think this year, the colorscapes have been quite amazing. The palette has been there. next. So that if you're coming from an area where you're suffering pretty hot temperatures just now, if we get 20 degrees centigrade, so that's about 70 Fahrenheit, that's really hot for us. And that's about it just now, actually. Next. But we enjoy it, and that's the main thing. And it's, as I say, it's a very vibrant and exciting place to be just now. I'll hand you over to Corrina, and we'll hear some proper music from here.
Thank you, Dorothy. Thanks, that was great. And we'll see a few more pictures later on. And for now, we will get a chance to hear some harp, Scottish harp, Clarsa. The Scottish harp community is quite innovative, as well as taking care of its traditional music. And Corrina Hewat is a singer, a harper, composer, educator, director, and a big thinker, really thinking through new ideas. She's one of Scotland's most original musicians and has been involved with a huge variety of projects, bands, and including Meshue as a duo with her, with pianist David Milligan, and Shine with Mary McMaster and Aileth McCormick. And the Scots supergroup is kind of a big band fusion, amazing band called The Unusual Suspects. So please welcome Corrina Hewat. Hi, Corrina.
Thanks very much, Ed.
Thank you.
And thanks, Dorothy, for showing us so many beautiful pictures of our own country. I love it. Okay, so I'm going to play you a few tunes. I'll start with a slow air. It's called The Isle of Agus, and I think I found this in the Simon Fraser fiddle collection. So Isle of Agus is an area just around, kind of near Bewley, which is north, just north of where I was brought up, in the Black Isle. So sorry, I'm all East Coast. I can't help it. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks. So that was the Isle of Aegis. Very lovely slow air there. Now, I figured what I'd do is I'd play some hornpipes next. Harps were not the most hornpipey of people. Harps and ships, well, you know. But I've written a couple, and I'd like to play them for you. The first one is called Gamery Skipper's Daughter. Or, well, actually, Gamery Skipper's Dochter. And it's written for a woman who, her dad was a fisherman, and she lives up in Gamery, which is near Aberdeenshire. Well, it's in Aberdeenshire. And it's a wee place called Gardenstown. It's very beautiful. And they're a lovely couple, and she plays harp as well. And she's just started this larger harp group up in Aberdeen. So I'm all for that. So I thought I'd write her a tune. And then I'll go on with a tune called Dalgetty Baby, which was written for a woman called Fiona Dalgetty, who was having her first child, gosh, maybe 5 or 6 years ago now. And she hadn't named it yet. It hadn't been born. It's either called Dalgetty Baby or Fraser, because that's what his name is. Thank you. Thank you. And I'll do one more. And this is a tune called Isabella de Vries. Now, Isabella is a wee girl who's been born to two poodle-loving parents. And the only reason I mention the fact that they're poodle-loving parents is because I noticed them in the Netherlands when I was teaching there one weekend, because there was two people who looked exactly like poodles. They had large, kind of large, you don't know what I mean, big poofy heads and strange, anyway. And then their dogs came in and they looked exactly the same. So I'm afraid when they had a small child, I had to write this little girl a tune. So it's just a little girl's tune. Okay. Thank
That's
you so
beautiful.
Much. Thanks, Ed, for asking me to be involved again. I love it. Thank
beautiful.
You.
Beautiful. Thank you for joining us. It's just, I love your, sometimes your playing is so simple and sometimes so rich and complex. It's just lovely to listen to. Thank you.
Thank you. Us harps have to, you know, that's why we're all making it up as we go along and arranging and things. There's nothing written down, you see, so we've got a very little history to draw from.
Well, you're making up something amazing. Then all the future harpers will draw on you for their inspiration. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Corrina. It was beautiful. We're going to be listening now to amazing singer and songwriter and multi-instrumentalist Emily Smith and Jamie McClennan. They've worked together for almost 20 years. Emily's won many awards for her heartfelt and polished singing, as you'll hear, and they write a lot of their own material, as they also draw material from the Scottish folk tradition and from Americana and beyond. So hello, Emily and Jamie, and welcome to our online concert.
Thank you very much. Great to see you all. It's a lovely taking a tour around Scotland from the comfort of your home. Although the real thing would be so much better, wouldn't it? But nice to see the pics and happy memories of when you've visited us in previous years as well, down here in the southwest. So we're going to start off with a song from our part of Scotland. Down here we have a big heritage of Robert Burns, but as well as Burns we have a famous poet who once came from these parts called Thomas Carlyle. So this song we're going to begin with is one of his poems called The Sower's Song, which Jamie and I here set to music a few years ago. So this is The Sower's Song. Now hands to seed, sheep boys, we step and we cast all times on wing. Partake of harvest joys, the seeds we sowed in spring. All there there's a pleasure to see, the sunshine cloak of red and green. This year the furrow will be years that are past have been. Fall gently and still, good corn, lie warm in your earthy bed, stand so yellow some bright morn, for man and beast must be fed. Son of 6,000 golden sires, on her kindly breast was born, one more your child requires. Steady and sure we go, with measure of stroke and step we grain so well, and you'll gladly reap. thank you very much. So we thought of our three songs we're going to play for you, that we would do an upbeat song in the middle, but I'm sorry to say it's an upbeat murder ballad, but that's just what you get in Southwest Scotland. So our traditions, it was very much a bit of a no man's land for a long, long time, and often fought over by different clans and groups of people. That's not what this ballad is about, but it's about two quarrelling sisters, or twa sisters in Scots, as Dorothy was mentioning earlier on. So,
only happy if you're sad.
You're only happy if you're sad in Scotland, that's it. So this is Twa Sisters.
Thank you.
So I should say that's a very, very old song, not a newly written murder ballad, but an old traditional tale where boiling people in lead was still common practice.
That's how you can tell it's not a newly written murder ballad.
Yes, long time gone, thankfully.
They were off our old album.
Yes, so both of those songs are from an album, an Emily Smith album called Echoes, which came out in 2014, I think. And the song we're going to leave you with tonight is from our duo album, as when we perform as Smith and McClennan, an album that's called Small Town Stories and came out just at the end of 2019, before the world changed. So this is one of our songs, but Jamie wrote this song around 2019, probably, or maybe start 2018, after visiting his family home back in New Zealand, where he's originally from. And so it's a song called Bricks and Mortar, but it's really, as we were rehearsing it the other day, it's really taken on quite a lot of new meaning, having spent most of the last 18 months inside our own house, who's taken care of us and given us safety. So we hope you enjoy it. Thanks very much for having us again as part of the event. It's been lovely to see you all again, and look forward to the rest of the show. Hopefully see you in person before too long.
Imagine doing a real life gig again.
Yeah.
In my old home, there's a life I used to leave behind every closed door, the story I would share. Sometimes I wonder if maybe I should have said that all the dreams I held were broken, but love left me that day. Now I see more than bricks and mortar, the walls of a fortress that keep me safe from safe.
Thank you, Emily and Jamie. It's beautiful.
Thank you.
As always. Yeah, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having us. Enjoy the rest of the gig, everybody.
Thank you. I want to introduce Dorothy again. She's going to show you a few more photos and maybe a little surprise in a moment. Thank you, Dorothy.
Okay. One of the highlights of one of the tours is going to visit Blair Castle, which is the homes of the Dukes of Atholl, traditional homes of the Dukes of Atholl. And there is where Niel Gow's fiddle resides and is looked after by the castle staff. And Niel Gow has a big focus and of that particular trip and is a huge influence on fiddle playing and fiddle music in Scotland. Next. So Ed's one of the few people, this is the fiddle that sits in the Great Hall. Normally it resides in this glass case. Ed's one of the few people that can is allowed to play it. And the next slide will show us next. That's it. Sorry. Next will show us the fiddle and he gets to check it over and play it for us in the library quite often, and playing some amazing tunes on it, to know that it's several hundred or a couple of hundred years old at least, if not a bit more. The music is so inspiring that next there's often an impromptu ceilidh as part of it, and people just can't just stop tapping their feet, they actually have to go up and dance. But anyway, as a special treat, Ed's not got his fiddle, but he's going to play some tunes that are associated with Gow. Thanks, Ed, over to you.
Well, I can't play Niel Gow's fiddle, as Dorothy said, because we're not over there. But
your arms aren't long enough.
That's right. So, but I thought, I just thought I might take an opportunity to play a few of the tunes that I especially like to play on the Gow fiddle today, just a few tunes. And this is a Scottish baroque violin, kind of like Gow's in a way. It's made by Joseph Rudiman. Made in 1774, the year that Robert Burns wrote his first song. And Joseph Rudiman was a great violin maker in Aberdeen, and he was actually the maker that Niel Gow traveled to when he slipped on ice and broke his fiddle, and he brought it to Rudiman to have it be fixed. So I thought it'd be appropriate to play a few tunes on this. It has the gut strings, which I bring over just in case the Gow fiddle needs a little attention. I was lucky enough years ago for head of U.S. Glenn Murray Society to suggest that I play and look after that fiddle a little bit. It sits in the glass case, and violins like to be played and looked after. So she got in touch with the Secretary of the Duke of Atholl and got permission for me to play, and I've played for our groups ever since. It's been a great honor. So I'd like to play these Gow-related tunes for you, three tunes. And the first one is a very long name. It's Niel Gow's Lamentation for James Moray, Esquire of Abercarney. There's a portrait of James Moray's father in the ballroom there at Blair Castle. And I'll go into a tune by Red Rob McIntosh, who was the musician, composer, fiddler that Niel Gow sent his son Nathaniel to learn music. And Nathaniel's the one that published about 20 collections that we call the Gow Collection, that's used to this day as a key source of Scottish music. And then I'll go into a tune by William Marshall, who is a contemporary of Gow's. In fact, they each wrote tunes to each other. There's a tune Marshall wrote called Compliments to Mr. Gow, and a tune that Gow wrote called Compliments to Mr. Marshall. So I'll start with the lament. Thank you. Dorothy has a few more pictures for us.
Yep. The music trips have a fairly flexible attitude to them in that we have to get to the next accommodation place, but what we do in between is up to the group itself, and the spontaneity is what makes some of the trips so special. So they're just taking advantage of the sunny day to have a little session. And the tower that you can see in the background is Glenfinnan Monument, which is a part of the tradition of the Jacobite uprisings next. But the bulk of these photographs are really just to give you an impression of the colour palette of Scotland, both in the landscape next and in the culture and the flora and fauna and so on. And next. And it has a big influence on, I think, as I said, I've said before, painting and so on, but to do with the music and the inspiration next. Whether it's stormy seas and these cliffs are about 150 feet high, and there are storms up in Shetland where this is taken at Esherness, where the spray from the waves comes over the top next. I'm sure that happens in the States as well, but it's quite impressive. But we also have lots of really good wildlife. This is the Bass Rock just nearby Edinburgh, which is the home for thousands and thousands of gannets. So the little speckly things that you can see dotted about are all the gannets next. And occasionally we get out to visit it, not to land in the rock, but to visit it anyway. Next, there's a lot of the flora is not necessarily giant. Next, it's just small stuff, but it's, as I said, the colours and the diversity of colours next is really quite impressive. There are lots of areas of Scotland, this is over in the Hebrides, where the farming culture is very organic. So there's hardly any herbicides and so on used, and it produces an amazing array of wildlife next, and flora next. And the color palettes that you get from that area in particular next has inspired what they make into Harris Tweed, and the various shades and patterns are taken from the sea and the landscape next, that the makers of the tweed use to this day. They're sometimes following traditional patterns, but quite often they're just being inspired by what is round about them. Next. And we see some of these occasionally, next, but it's quite often the wildlife itself. We don't have big things like bears, next, or lynx or tigers or anything like that. We just have fairly cuddly animals, next, that are what we're renowned for, I think, next. The only cuddly animal that we don't really like is called the midgie, but I'm sure you have black fly in the States, so we occasionally have that as well. Next. But we cope with it, whatever. So just next. Just enjoy the next few photographs because they're just next. I'll stop saying next. Because next. Because it's just the sorts of things that we come across as we're walking around. Next. 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 And I'll leave you with this, and let's enjoy some really nice music from Finn and Sarah, some great musicians. Thanks, Ed.
Thank you, Dorothy. Beautiful photos and memories of beautiful places. I can almost smell the fresh air. So we're going to have a continue our concert with some music from Finn Moore and Sarah Hoy. I first met Finn's father, Hamish, in the 80s, and he was a pioneer in the revival of the Scottish small pipes and made them. He makes all sorts of pipes, and Finn has taken over making the pipes, and he's going to be playing. He also teaches and performs on the small pipes, border pipes, Highland pipes, and he'll tell you about his instrument today. Sarah Hoy is a fiddler, and her father, Derek, was integral to the Scottish traditional music scene. Both of them, well, Finn teaches each year at the music and dance festival called Kjolas in South Uist, which is a really great event. So let's welcome, hello, Finn and Sarah. I hope you put the baby to bed and you're all set. There we go. Great to see you, and thanks for joining us.
It's lovely to join you tonight.
Okay, well, we're going to kick off with some jigs, and then we're just going to fire straight on. So here's a set of four jigs.
Thank you. you very much.
Thanks very much.
I take a terrible, I don't know if you see, have this saying in America, but a fit of the giggles during that, because a box appeared on our screen, some computer thing, and Finn every now and then just peeked out from behind it. It's really badly distracting.
Yeah.
I think we'd be used to Zoom by now. The last tune in that set was written by a really good friend of ours, Ian McDonald, or Ian the Whaler, as he might be known to some people. He lives up in Bimbecula, and he's the musical director of the festival that Ed mentioned earlier, Keolis. And he wrote that tune for his wife when she had a very unfortunate incident when she ordered too many carafes of wine. The best kind of incident. So that's called Annie's Carafe. You going to say a few words?
I can't. So Ed was mentioning about the pipes, and the pipes I'm playing tonight are Scottish small pipes. And at the last concert we did, thanks very much for asking me back, I'd mentioned a wee bit about the pipes that my grandfather had made for myself, and I played a tune that was one of his favourite ones. So the Scottish small pipes, these ones I'm playing tonight, are actually just a notch up from the ones that my grandfather made, because they're in the key of D instead of the key of C, which makes it a wee bit easier for Sarah to play with. And yeah, so a set of Scottish small pipes, kind of similar to Northumberland pipes or Border pipes and Ellen pipes, where you're using your bellows to get the air into them, and are much more sociable at this time of the evening, and also great for playing along. So the kind of the theme of the grandfathers, we thought it'd be nice for Sarah to mention a wee bit about her grandfather and all his stuff. So over to you.
My grandfather's name was Andy Coogan, and he grew up in the Gorbals in Glasgow, which was a name, a place that was really famous for an area of high deprivation. And Grandpa was just such an inspirational character. He had kind of three parts to his life. He grew up in the Gorbals, where he talked about how many incredible people he met, and he called it a melting pot of cultures. And then in the middle part of his life, he was a Japanese prisoner of war. And then when he came home, he moved up to the east coast of Scotland to Carnoustie, and he was a fantastic athlete, and his latterly he was training a lot of young athletes and things. So he was just such an inspirational character. And he passed away about 3 or 4 years ago now, and he was a week off of his 100th birthday. So good, strong stock. So I'll just play a wee tune for him. He was a fantastic storyteller, joker, prankster, and also a really fantastic singer. And one of his big favourites was Red Red Rose. So if you fancy it tonight, you could give a sing along or get up for a wee waltz around. Thank you. Some real applause. I don't know if people believe in sings, but while I was playing that, I was thinking of that high note in the second part, where it used to always be a bit of a lottery whether Grandpa would make it. 9 times out of 10, he did. But just when I was playing that, the kitchen lights went off.
And I was thinking, Sarah mentioned that you could sing along or dance, but she wasn't actually giving that instruction to me. She wasn't wanting me to sing along at all. So you're all very lucky that I didn't take that one on. So we're going to play one more set. Thanks very much for having us along again, Ed and all the backroom team. I know Neil's helping out, and Dorothy and Margaret. It's a weird place we're living in at the moment, but hopefully we'll all get back to a bit more normal and seeing people. And it's great, although these things are really have kept it all going, and it's amazing to think that we're sitting here in our living room playing to all you guys. So thanks very much for coming along as well. And yeah, we're just going to play one last set, a wee 9/8 march, not so kind of common in Scotland or anywhere really, called Sandy St. James Dumont, and then into a set of reels. And with the last one being a tune I wrote, you're chatting about all the different places you go in Scotland. One of the places between Blair Athol and where my workshop is the Hermitage. And friends of myself were getting married there in the woods, and they asked me to write a tune. So I called it Wedding in the Woods. So if you ever do get over and you're just north of Dunkeld, just a wee bit north of where Niel Gow lived, actually, the Hermitage is a great walk. And this tune kind of was played there for the first time when they were getting married. So here we go. Thanks very much. Thank you. very much.
Oh.
Thank you very much. Thanks That's very fantastic. Much for having us.
Thank you for joining us. It was really great to hear you. What a great combination. And of course, the fiddlers, we love to have pipers play that kind of pipe so we can hear ourselves too. It was really nice. So we'll have one more performer to join us. Sandy Brechin is a brilliant, entertaining accordion player. I love some of the titles of his CDs, like Out of His Box and Out of His Tree, and his Kaylee band, The Sensational Jimmy Shandrick's Experience. He's played with bands Silihu, Burach, the Sandy Brechin band, and toured everywhere, and he's very busy. He was just in England at a festival yesterday, or this morning, I suppose. Ewan Wilkinson will be playing guitar with him, and you'll hear he has a really beautiful, powerful voice. So please welcome Sandy and Ewan. Thanks for joining us, you guys.
Hello there.
Hello.
We've just got a barking dog here. She's been really quiet the last few hours, and then she's just decided to go mental. Perfect timing.
Well, you didn't tell me it was a trio.
You're barking. It's not my friend Ewan.
You didn't tell me it was a trio.
Oh, come on. Let's bring her in the picture. Right, here's Heidi.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Heidi plays the accordion with her little paw. Oh, wow. That's better than me. Try again, Heidi. Ooh. Ba ba black sheep, have you any paws? Oh, she's so good. She's so clever. She's not even my dog.
Yeah, can you stop talking to my dog, please?
Oh, my hands kind of, they smell kind of weird, but good.
Mm. Why are you not barking now? That was something you should have barked at. That's...
So I see you have an extra vocalist in Heidi, right?
Yeah.
Thank you. Look forward to your tunes.
Do you want us to play, or have you got more interesting pictures to precede us with?
No, that was all of Scotland, all in one.
Oh, you've done all of Scotland, right? No, yeah. Just go for it. We're looking forward to another picture show. The cinemas have been closed for a year here, so we were really looking forward to that. Never mind. Let's just go.
In case anybody's wondering, this is a microphone, and it's not really big. It's just
wow, it's massive.
It's just very close.
Okay, there's a little set of reels here. I won't bother telling you the names. Might tell you them after. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. much. That was Carney's Cantor and Andy Breen's Reel and finally the Clydesdale Lassies. And that was an exciting tune set to start off with, but that's our only tune set because now we want to spend the rest of the concert appreciating fully the wonderful voice of Heidi the dog. Ewan, the singer.
Thank you.
And maybe Heidi the dog also. She loves to accompany our owner. Oh, as I do. No,
really, really don't do that. She will start barking again. What's been nice, the nice thing about this lockdown where we've not been playing is going back to old material we've been singing for ages, playing for ages.
I thought you were going to say not having to talk to anybody.
Well, that's been quite good as well, yeah. Not hearing the accordion. But the hearing old material afresh, things that we were a bit tired of. Now a year and a half later, it's all nice and new to us again. So
yeah, so most people spend lockdown a year in lockdown learning new material, whereas we just did absolutely nothing, went back to the old stuff, and hey, it's just like brand new.
It's great. So this is a song I've been singing for
losers
a very long time. It comes from my part of the world, from the Scottish Borders. I'm sure lots of you know it, so please do sing along, and you can sing along as well if you'd like,
Thank
Sandy.
You.
Thank you. Yeah. Called the Broom of the Cowden Knowes. The Cowden Knowes has been a little farmer landed estate near Earlston in Berwickshire, and the broom being a yellow blossomed plant on the hills and the borders.
Presumably it was some kind of brush, it's a revelation. Clap along in your screens, folks. Doesn't matter what your timing's like.
I can't hear you.
We can't hear you anyway.
How blithes I each morn to see my last Marion Hill. She tripped, burned, and ran to me. I met her way goodwill. Oh, the broom, the bonny, bonny broom. Broom o' the Cowden Knowes. Fain would I be in my country, heard in my fellow's yows. Hard fate that I should banish be. Young weary I am the more, for I hail the fairest lass that ever yet was born. And oh, the broom, the bonny, bonny broom, broom o' the Cowden Knowes. Fain would I be in my country, heard in my feathers yows. Fain would I be in my Thank you. Thank you for all the applause. I hope there's applause. Can't hear it. Oops. Gonna finish off our reset with that. Another song. As I was saying about old material, this is a song I wrote, it must be about 20 years ago, all about a friend of mine who was in the Merchant Navy. It's called Far From the Sea, because I come from the town of Peebles on the Scottish borders, which is about 90 miles from the sea, so you can't get much further away from the sea in Scotland. And it's all about some of the stories he told me about his life as he was on that, as a merchant seaman. So his guitar hasn't been played in a long time. It's really humid today in Edinburgh. We're meant to have thunderstorms today, so the guitar does not like that either. The accordion's okay, that's fine.
It's fairly indestructible.
Unfortunately, yeah.
Been struck a few times by a lightning. I was slightly injured, the accordion was fine.
It's Far From the Sea. That wee bit then, that was the storm. Yes. This is hard work. I can't believe we used to do this for hours at a time.
Man, that was 15 minutes. I'm good. Hand me the dog, Ewan. I'm a little bit sweaty. Hand me the dog.
Oh, no, don't let dog.
Come on.
Heidi, come here.
Heidi, come on.
Oh, no, she's barking now. Heidi, no, she's not happy.
Heidi. Come here, Heidi. I don't know why she's so scared.
Come here, yeah, it's a good doggy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, under the armpit as well. Oh, yeah, good, good. Oh, she's playing again. Listen. Oh, it's three blind mice this time. Oh, that's an unfortunate shot. Sorry, folks. Sorry. Can we haze the spot out, Ed?
Can Heidi play us a set?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so embarrassed America had to see this.
Again, to be
beyond my control.
Can you leave my dog alone, please?
This could be a wonderful promotion shot for a new album. Forget Sandy and Ewan. Sandy and Heidi. Yeah. Wait. How to play the accordion with your dog's bottom.
You could do an instructional video.
Yeah.
Are you have another set of tunes for us?
No.
You forgot them all?
Excuse me, will I extract this dog?
Well.
Let's get somebody pretty in the shot. Come in.
There we go.
Thank you, Chelsea. This is my local assistant, Chelsea.
This is our producer for the evening, yes. And animal handler.
Our handler, yes. A selection of jigs, yeah? Was that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Awesome. Great.
Ed, you look like a DJ there with the headphones. I'm going to have to get a set of phones myself.
It's just for the look, you know.
Well, yes, this is a new one we just made out today. So I start with beatboxing, and Ewan comes in. Okay, yeah, take it away. Oh, no, just kidding. Okay, DAD.
Yes.
Okay, set of jigs. Thank you.
Great. Thank you so much. I want to thank everybody for being here, for joining us today. I want to thank Sandy and Ewan for performing, and Heidi as well. Thanks to Alistair McCulloch and Gila Breechin McMillan, Corrina Hewat, Emily Smith, and Jamie McLennan, Finn Moore and Sarah Hoy. Thanks to Dorothy for the photos. Thanks to Neil for helping me manage things. And thank you all for coming, because if you hadn't shown up, it would just be a rehearsal. So I'm going to ask you all to unmute yourselves, and please give all of these great musicians a big round of applause.
Woo-hoo! Thank you.